Good morning, you listen to FloorDaily.net, and I'm Kemp Haar. This morning, my guest is Jay Gould, the CEO with Interface. Jay, how you doing?
Very well, Kemp. Nice to talk to you.
Yeah, it's good to talk to you. You've got some big news around Interface's intent to buy Nora, and we'll get into that in just a minute. It's been 6 months or so since we've talked. Tell us how Interface is doing.
Business is good. I'm happy to say we're facing a very robust macroeconomic environment, really globally.
Yeah.
We had an outstanding first quarter, and you know, the last time I talked to the street, we talked about our orders being up 12% as we headed into the second quarter. So feeling really good about our performance.
Okay, so we've done some annual reports recently, and I've got some stats here in front of me. Basically, Interface is a global company, around $1 billion in sales in 17, just under that. Publicly traded, so most of these numbers are easy to access. In the U.S., you play mostly in modular carpet tile, but you have about 25 to 30 million in sales in the LVT business. Little diversity there. You just came back from NeoCon and did a great job in your presentation there. Looks like you're touching two of the big trends there, both resi-mercial and biophilia. And you also made a big announcement about all your products being carbon neutral, right?
Yes, sir. That was a big move. It was really kind of the culmination of 20 years of working on sustainability to be able to move the entire company to being carbon neutral. We had to buy some minor offsets to do that, but I think in the next 2 to 3 years, we'll be able to achieve that carbon neutrality without buying any offsets.
Okay.
So pretty exciting times from a sustainability perspective.
Yeah, and that continues to build you as the brand that's recognized as being one of the leaders in sustainability, right?
Yes, we are, and I'm happy to say that the conversation around climate take-back and our attempt to demonstrate that companies can operate in carbon-negative business models is really taking hold. You know, this wild notion that we talked about 2 years ago about loving carbon is really making an impact, not only in the architectural community, but in building at large.
All right, well, let's talk about Nora. And speaking about branding, too, Nora, very strong brand, well-known globally, a company that's based in Germany.
Weinheim, yes.
Thank you. And it's been privately held, but then also some transactions with private equity firms. There was a Capitan firm that sold it in 16 to Intermediate Capital Group, and then that's who you're buying it from. They do about $280 million in rubber flooring globally. The stock transaction is about a $420 million transaction, right?
All of that's correct. And I'll tell you, Kemp, as we looked around at the commercial flooring business around the world, we just fell in love with the Nora brand. I mean, its reputation in the market around performance, around design, innovation, and sustainability were all really positive. And I've been working on this deal for a year.
Yeah.
And as I've got to know the people at Nora, they really fit the value systems of Interface.
Mm-hmm.
And as I talk to customers about this, you know, again, that brand reputation really resonates with customers. And so we were thrilled to be able to add on to our resilient flooring. So in addition to LVT, now having rubber products.
Mm-hmm.
The customer reaction to us moving beyond carpet tile has been incredibly positive, Kemp.
Yeah, that's good. All right, so let's talk a little bit about the strategy. We talked offline a minute ago about some of this, but why don't you go ahead and just verbalize why Nora versus some of the other options that are out there?
We looked at the commercial flooring market, and that's our intention, is to be 100% commercial, so we don't look at residential brands.
Yeah.
But on the commercial side, the Nora brand was so strong in the healthcare arena,
mm-hmm.
in life sciences, in education,
yeah.
and it really helps extend our relationship in those verticals. In addition to that, we thought we could help accelerate the Nora growth by our geographic reach.
Mm-hmm. It makes you stronger with a bundling offering to some of these sectors. As you say, it's strong brand commercial, especially specified A&D. That's where they live, right?
Yes, sir. They're 100% commercial and virtually 100% specified, and we love that piece of the business.
This is supposed to close in a few months if there's no regulatory issues, right?
It'll take 6 to 10 weeks to close.
All right. And then as you go to market, I'm sure this is probably a little premature question, but will you continue to have a Nora brand?
We will continue to offer the Nora brand, yes. We think it's an appropriate brand for the rubber flooring market.
Uh-huh.
So the company will be Interface, but we'll keep the Nora brand.
One other quick comment statistically. Looks like the rubber market, global rubber market, according to your press release, is a $1 billion market, and they're a market share leader. And the other players there, I think Mannington owns Burke, and then Tarkett owns Johnsonite. And so those three primarily control that market, don't they?
That's right, in the U.S., that's right.
Okay.
It's a fairly fragmented business around the world, but those are the key players in the U.S.
And a key part of where rubber is used, it is recognized in the resilient category as the performance offering, right?
That's right, and we are calling this our entry into performance flooring. I think ultimately we could have other products in that segment.
Another thing real quick while I've got you, you talk about the LVT business. Last year you did $25 million, and your plan in 18 is to double that. Are you on track with that?
We are. Yep, we should definitely do $50 million in LVT this year.
Okay, Jay. Well, it's great to talk to you and get to our listeners up on why Interface decided to buy Nora. Again, been talking to Jay Gould, the CEO with Interface, and you've been listening to Kemphar and FloridaLA.net.